Hello, let's see the code of the sensor. Here we have a printf that says how many elements we want for our array. We have a scanf. We scan for the variable n. We scanf. We scan an integer and we put it at the memory address n. This is the memory address. It's an integer. With scanf, we scan from the standard input file for an integer and we assign the variable n. And we have to get the current return. So that's why here I call the getChar function in order to read the current return. After that, with malloc, I'll allocate some memory, new positions of integers, and I assign this memory area inside our memory to the variable n. This is a pointer who points to an integer. You can find inside this include here a standard library, the header file. After that, with an integer I say that I fill up the array, the V array, with random values between 0 and the power of n into power of 2. I raise the n variable to the power of 2 and I take random values between this area, between area 0 and this here, these numbers here. After that, I call the print function. After that, I call the sensor function. And after that, I call again the print file, print on the screen the values of the V integer. The V integer, what it does? It just prints the values of this parameter here, of this array here, of this array of integers. This is the dimension, this is the array we send from our main, and this is the dimension of the array, n. I assign the dimension to a helping variable integer named I, and I say while I is greater than 0, I print on the screen the values of this array here, and then I decrease the counter. This is the cell sort. It has three for loops, and let me explain you how the sensor works. I'll show you. This is the sensor. First, we have this, let's say that this is our array here from 0 to n minus 1. Let's say that this is our array here. The gap is in the middle, so points in at the middle, in the middle of our array is the middle element. After that it goes here. After that it goes here. let's say for the first time, that is in the middle of the array. After that, the I takes values from gap, from the value of the variable gap till the n minus 1, and this increases. So let's say that the I is here. After that, the I will go here. After that, the I will go here, and it continues until it reaches this value here. And so the j is I minus the gap. So first will be this value here. In the next iteration, I will be here. So the J will be here. After that, the J will go here, and after that, the J will go here. So it will compare this value and this value here, the J plus the gap. If this is less, this value here is greater than this value here, these two memory addresses will swap its values, their values. Okay, the same will happen for this position and this position. And let's say that the I has reached n minus 1, then the J will compare this value here and this value here, the middle and the last position of the array, and after that it will compare the middle and the first position of the array. Now, if the gap is this value here, and the I is here, then the I will go here. So the J will compare the first position and this position here. This position here. After that, the I will be here. So J will compare this position and this position here. After that, it will compare this position with this position. So all the positions will be compared. Okay, we will not lose any of our elements. Okay, this is the cell sort. Let's run it to see. Let's give 11 elements, and you see it works. It has sorted the elements. Let's end one more time. Okay. That's it. Thank you very much. Goodbye.